Welcome to the THirD BeNCHERS YouTube channel. Today we will discuss CSIR LifeScience June 2016 Part A. Question number 8. AB and CD are chords of a circle subtending 60 and 120 degrees respectively at the same point on the circumference of the circle. Then AB is to CD is what? So AB and CD are the two chords of a circle and they subtend an angle of 60 and 120 degree at this common point P. Now we have to find the ratio of this AB and CD. We have to find the length and find its ratio. So for this sum, we tend to subtend another triangle using the point O, that is using the center of the circle. We do this because when we take the whole circle, for example ABP or triangle CDP, we end up with three unknown values. We end up with three unknown lengths. So that is difficult. So we subtend another triangle using the center of the circle so that we eliminate one of its sides by its radius, because radius is common for all the sides. Similarly here, so these two are the radius. Now taking the triangle that we subtended with 60 degree, that is triangle AOB, let us zoom in. This forms a right angle triangle. So let this be E. So taking in that triangle, right angle triangle, EOB so the angle tends to be double when we subtend it here, so it will be 120. So half of 120 will be 60. So this is 60 and we have to find this BE. So sine 60 degree is equal to BE by hypotenuse, that is OB. So BE by R, we need BE. So BE is equal to sine 60 is root 3 by 2 into R. As we have AB, AB is twice of BE. So AB is equal to 2 into root 3 by 2 into R. So which is equal to root 3 R. This is AB. And taking the triangle, taking this triangle COB, and in that taking the right angle triangle, as I told, the angle doubles here. So it is 240 here. When we take this right angle triangle, it is O, let this be F, this point. So OFD, this angle is 240. So half of 240 is 120. And we need this DF. By Pythagoras theorem, sine 120 is opposite FD by hypotenuse is OD. So OD tends to be R, which is the radius, and FD is what we have to find. So FD is equal to R into sine 120. So to calculate 120, R is sine 180 degree minus 60 degree is 120. So since this lies in the positive quadrant, we get sine 60 degree, which is equal to root 3 by 2 into R. Similarly, for getting CD, CD is twice of FD. So CD is equal to 2 into root 3 by 2 into R, which is equal to root 3 R. Now the ratio of AB into CD is root 3 R by root 3 R, which is equal to 1 by 1. And in case of ratio, it is represented as 1 is to 1. So option 3 is the right answer. Which of the following inferences can be drawn from the above graph? So this graph shows the percentage change over previous years of the qualifying students of three subjects, physics, chemistry and biology. So this is physics, this is chemistry and this is biology. And the options shows the qualifying students of the various subjects with respect to the years. So let us calculate the number of students qualifying in each year from 2013, 14 and 15 and look into the options. First, let us consider that in 2013 and 2014 and 2015. So, let us consider the initial percentage of students is 100% in all the three. So, it is 100%, 100% and 100%. So, in 2014, it is 10% rise. So, a 10% rise of 100 is 10, which is like 100 into 10% is 10. So, 100 plus 10 is equal to 110. So, it is 110 here. And similarly, a 5% increase is 5. It is again 105. And a 10% decrease is 90. And considering this, we have to calculate the next percentage, that is a 10% decrease. A 10% of 110 is 11. So, it is 99. Similarly, a 8% increase in 105. 105, 8% increase, 1.05 into 8, which corresponds to 8.4. So, 105 plus 8.4 corresponds to 113.4. So, let us write it as 113. And similarly, a 10% increase from 90 is again 10. Sorry. 90 from a 10% will correspond to 9. So, it is 9. So, 90 plus 9 gives 99. So, it is 99 students. Now let us look into the options and find for the correct option. The total number of students qualifying in physics in 2015 and 14 is the same. So physics 14 and 15 is the same. No, it is not same. So this is not the right answer. The number of students qualifying in biology in 2015 is less than 2013. So in 2015 it is 99. And in 2013 it is 100%. So yes, this one is right. And the number of chemistry qualifying students in 2015 must be more than the number of students who qualified in biology in 2014. So, even though the number of students is same, that is 100%, this means this 100% corresponds to the actual number of students who wrote in 2013. And that doesn't mean that it is 100% equal in all. So, you can't compare chemistry with biology. So, this option cannot be valid. And the number of physics qualifying students in 2015 is equal to the number of students in biology that qualified in 14. So physics and biology, two different groups cannot be compared because its initial value is different. So this can also be not right. So option 2 is the right answer. Minimum number of moves required to transform figure 1 to figure 2. A move is defined as removing a coin and placing it in such that it touches other two coins in new position. So, number of moves for transformation from this to this. This one, it is very easy. I will show here. So, this one is one move. It is touching two coins. And this one is the second move. So, the number of moves, minimum number of moves is 2. Relationship among the numbers in each corner square is given as that in the other corner squares. What is a missing number? So, there is some logic here. You can see 7, 9 plus 2, 9. 8 plus 2, 10. 3 plus 2, 5. So, 4 plus 2 will be 6. So, third one is the right answer. Which of the following best approximates sine 0.5 degree? So, we don't know what is sine 0.5 and all. We know only sine 30, sine 60 and all. So, we know that sine 0 is 0. So sine 0.5 also should be near to 0.5. But you don't get misleaded by 0.5. This is because it is conversion. There is a conversion of radians to degrees. Radians to degrees. So, for the conversion of degrees to radians, we have to multiply it by pi by 180. So, where pi is equal to 3.14 by 180. So, option 2 is the right answer. What comes next in the sequence? This also is very simple. Can see this is the top portion of A, B, C and D. So the next one will be E, obviously. So third one is the right answer. Which of the following statements is logically incorrect? Logically incorrect. So first one is I always speak the truth. Then I occasionally lie. Third one is I occasionally speak the truth. And fourth one is I always lie. So the fourth one seems to be logically incorrect, because lie means it is also like resting. So you can't always lie. So means fourth one is the right answer. Thank you for watching.